What's up, beautiful summer ladies and gents, wherever you are in the world. I'm sure it's really hot right now. It is so hot right here in Maryland, where I'm based out of. So my name is Khadija. I am the CEO and brand owner, creative director. I wear many hats. And I'm a leading expert in henna hair color and Ayurvedic hair care. I do beautiful henna body art. I also do jagua. And believe it or not, I am the mom of six children. So let's get into the summer fun of hair care. And please watch to the end, because I'm actually gonna share with you some of the makeup I have on today. Many of you are probably sweating a lot more. I know I am under my hijab. I'll be like, ooh, sweaty. You know, just enjoying maybe the ocean, beaches, maybe just the pool. Maybe you're just hosing yourself with a hose. If you know, you live in different climates, so it's dry and humidity. Do you know that that affects your hair as well? Okay, story time. My Nana, my mother's mother. So she used to yell at me because many of you might not have known, I wasn't always Muslim. I was brought up in a Christian household and always believed in God, okay? So I converted to Islam when I was 17. My point being is I didn't cover my hair because as a teenager, I wasn't Muslim. Anyhow, I used to wash my hair in the morning and walk out of the house in the dead of winter. Yes, the dead of winter, my hair would be brick hard, icicles, like frozen. But that being said, is the different changes in weather should trigger your hair regimen. Your hair regimen needs to be tweaked a little bit more according to the weather and the environment you live in. You know, in the summer months, usually there's a lot more humidity. And if you live, let's say on the East Coast, there is a lot of humidity. There's definitely the dry areas, Arizona, California for sure, super dry. It's very important in this DIY world of henna to understand that you're learning your hair and all the science that goes around that. Where do we start? Let's start with those of you going to the pool, you know, you want to retain moisture, you're going to the ocean, going to the beach, you're going on vacation. So I have the cleansing co-washes, which are very, very restorative. I highly recommend them as part of your Ayurvedic hair regimen, for sure. Your henna hair coloring, these are so restorative. This needs to be in your baggage. Mind you, you can't put this size in your carry-on, but you can check your bag and you can have this in there. You can travel with this for sure. You could put this on your hair all throughout, put a cap, especially if you're going to be going into a pool that might have chlorine, you know, but it is safe. You can go to the ocean, you could do all the things that you want to do, but you can use this as a leave-in before you go into the water, and that really does protect your hair and keep in and lock the moisture, because oftentimes when you're getting exposed to other, you know, water and chlorine and all these other things, the beach, sand, wherever you may be sweating, you were gonna have to wash it out again, right? So if you're really concerned about that, you can definitely do that. That works really, really well. Then we have the hibiscus restorative, keyword up, restorative hair mask. This you can also travel with and on the go. It's ready to use even if you wanna go home. Pop it out of the freezer, because you should keep these in the freezer. It probably takes like 30 minutes to like thaw out. It's pretty much thawing out real right now. And you can use this as a mask treatment on your hair after you're done everything and you've enjoyed your whole day. Pop this in your hair. You know, don't overthink it. Just massage it into your hair, get it into your scalp. Keep it simple. It doesn't have to be so extra extravagant. So restorative, the hibiscus, restorative mask. It's so good for that. And last but not least, after you're done that, you can use the Moroccan, open this, the Moroccan Argan Oil. Ooh, I love this bottle. The Moroccan Argan Oil. You could definitely use the Moroccan Argan Oil to leave in your hair. Put it onto damp hair, locks in even more moisture. So let's say, you know, you're just gonna go out and you're doing your thing. You're like, I don't really wanna leave maybe a conditioner like the cleansing co-wash. I don't wanna leave it in this time. You can use the Moroccan Argan Oil to use as a leave-in in your hair as well. Just put as much as you need. It protects it from the heat, from the sun. It is really, really good at doing that. And then if you want, you could wash it out later. You know, just rinse it all out. You don't necessarily have to shampoo a lot of these things out, because you don't want to bring your hair back to a dry state. If your hair is on the oily side, then yes, you can use a shampoo, but usually, you know, you try to either rinse it out or use a cleansing co-wash to kind of like leave some of those benefits in too. You don't want to just pull it back out. These would definitely be my summer favorite leave-ins to protect your hair, to restore dryness. And did you know that doing protective styles locks in moisture at the same time? Yes, it helps your hair retain the moisture by doing protective styles. And, oh, I have an announcement. Oh, I almost forgot to tell you guys, we have a special announcement. We are gonna be having a 30-day hair challenge. And we're gonna do one every single month. Yes, we are starting in July. And how it's gonna work is I'm gonna come on live. I will let you guys know when it starts and when that live will happen. And we're gonna just jump right into it. It's gonna be a lot of fun. So are you guys ready for the special tidbit that I have for you about the makeup I have on? I really wanna share my favorite go-tos. So I have Glam Go on. It's just like a little bit of a tint moisturizer that I put on just to like give me a little pop. And then after I do that, then I do my eyes. I use Marc Jacobs, and that's like called it's a really beautiful, just a bluish shade called Whirlpool. And then I have their Velvet, you know, mascara on. I use that from Marc Jacobs as well. I love it so much because it works so well. Nothing smears or runs on my eyes, which is really important to me because I'm busy, I'm on the go, I'm all over the place. You know, busy mom life. Believe it or not, I am the mom of 6 children. And then I finished it up with a little bit of Fenty, beautiful like little dusting of this rosy highlighter that they have, I absolutely love. And you just brush it on, boom, boom, boom. It gives you a little sparkle. For me, it's the pink one that does a lot of like highlighting for my skin tone. I really like it. It looks really great. It's easy to use, and boom, I'm done. If you want to be notified, don't forget, you gotta hit the little bell, you gotta subscribe, you gotta follow and do all that good stuff, and to stay tuned, you know. And I want to say thank you so much to all the subscribers that have been following the channel. We have been growing like crazy. You guys are amazing. You guys are so adorable. I love hearing from you. So post your questions, give me your feedback, let me know what's going on, and you know what kind of hair struggles you have, especially we're talking about the summertime. July, we're gonna be starting a 30-day hair challenge, and we're gonna be talking about summer hair in that challenge. So let's go, let's do it. I will see you next time.